Welcome to Off the Field with me, Anish Gwenim. This is episode 3, where we're talking about sports for marks or marks for sports. Is there a relationship between education and the field? Do you think education can bring value to the players on the field? Do you think the players can bring value to your books? We're going to find out shortly. I'm with Mohini. What Mohini just explained to you was a situation where we spoke about a football game where the team has gone down by one goal with how many minutes?
Just 5.
5 minutes left to get over. What are we going to do? How are we going to handle the situation? To explain the situation to us, Mohini and me are both players and we've called in two sets of coaches. Set of one are coaches who only study. They don't play any sort of sport. They're only studying the whole day. And then we've got another set of coaches. Who are they?
The players.
They're actual players who only play and they don't even study. Do both of them bring value to our answer to this question? So we have with us Coach Prachi and Coach Sandeep. Now Prachi and Sandeep have not played much of sport. They've studied, they've focused so much on their education. But they're here to give us their view on a situation which Mohini and me presented to them. Prachi and Sandeep, tell us. We are down by one goal. We have 5 minutes left, right?
Yeah.
What should we do, Prachi?
Firstly, you have to be calm.
Calm? So Mohini, I think she's telling us to be calm. Coach Sandeep?
You all must encourage your players' confidence level.
Encourage the confidence. So we need to be more confident. That's what he's saying, be more confident. What else, Coach Prachi?
You have to understand the situation.
Yes. So understand. We need to be more understanding. Coach Sandeep?
You must know the player's trick. What is their trick?
So know their strengths.
Yes.
So know the opposition's strengths. So opposite team's strengths. So strengths of the team. What else, Coach Prachi?
Also, you have to be physically strong as well as mentally.
But I am. There's 5 minutes left for the match to get over. I'm scared. How do I handle this?
You must plan.
Plan?
You must
plan the next 5 minutes. Is that what you're saying? So we need to plan the next 5 minutes. Is there anything else you think we should do?
And you should put your own tricks to stop the player.
So believe in what we are doing.
Yes.
Is that what you're saying? So believe in ourselves. There's number 6 now, Mohini. We have 6 points. Believe in ourselves.
Believe in yourself.
Are you all both telling me that you all have not played any sport in your life?
No.
Are you all telling me that you all are so good in your studies and all of these situations have come from your books?
No.
Yes. Do you understand that you are now speaking to a team and giving me advice as a coach? Thank you so much. Coach Prachi and Coach Sandeep, who came right now and stood next to us, gave us suggestions on how to handle this situation where we have 1-0 down and we've got 5 minutes left. Who would say that they are nerds? Who would say that they have never played any form of sport in their life? We see the value that education has already brought to the field. Next, we've got two coaches who are joining us who play sports and they're going to give us their view. They do not study and they're still going to tell us how they would handle the situation. Let's watch. I now have two coaches with me who love sports. I've got Coach Babita and I've got Coach Venkatesh, who've joined us, Mohini and me, to understand how we can handle this situation better. As you're all aware of what the situation is, we've got 5 minutes left, we need to score, and we're under a lot of pressure. Coach Babita, what should we do?
First, we have to stay calm.
Stay
First
calm?
Thing.
Okay, so we need to
stay calm.
And how do we stay calm?
So we have to listen our captain.
So listen. Listening is the first thing. So listening is step one to being calm. So she says listen. Okay. What else should we do, Coach Venkatesh?
And don't be hyper.
Don't be hyper. So you're saying
Don't be stressed.
Don't be scared. So don't get scared. What else should we do, Coach Babita?
Communication is the main thing.
Communication? How is communication important?
When the captain is telling you to do this, that, you have to listen him and he's telling you have to do that.
Okay, so communication. Mm-hmm. Communication is important. So communication, what else, Coach Venkatesh? What else do you think we should do? You said we need to, you know, not be scared of our captain. Is there any other point that you all can think of, both of you, right now?
Always think that we are going for a victory. Like a war, we have to win that.
So we have to win.
Yeah.
So we have to win. That's what she's saying. We have to win.
And
okay.
Think that you can do a score.
So think.
Yeah.
So we can do it, right? So we have
the
to
positive.
Believe the positive.
Yeah.
So be positive is what she said. Be positive. Thank you. You know, before you all came in, we had two coaches who've never played sport in their life. And we are going to show you all how what you all said and what they said are so similar and so resourceful. We'll be back.
The all-new Prudent app is here. Watch news videos and bulletins on the go. Catch up with all your favorite programs. Never miss a breaking news with Prudent notification. Watch Prudent TV live on your phone. All new features and a brand new Prudent app available for Android and iOS.
The situation that Mohini and me saw was we were down by 5, we had to score, we were under so much of pressure. What we did was we got two sets of coaches. Set one were coaches who?
Never played.
Correct, so they've only studied. And the other set of coaches were?
The players.
Who actually have played. Yeah. And we've heard both of them give their view on it. Now let's watch their views. This is something which you all have not seen as well. So the ones who study, the nerds, as I call you all with love, have said, you need to be calm, you need to be confident, you need to be understanding, you need to believe in your strength, you need to have a plan, and most importantly, you need to believe that you can manage this in the last 5 minutes. Correct? Here's what your friends have said. They don't study much. They don't study as much as you. But look how it's matched. For all of this, it begins with listening. It also moves to, you can't be scared. There's 5 minutes left for a match to get over. Then communication. For all of this to work, we need to communicate with each other. Then we have to win, right? We have to win. This approach would give us the first goal. After we get the first goal, we go for the victory. And then the last point for all of this to work is?
Be positive.
That's it. And friends, if you see, we've got two sets of people in the classroom, the smart ones and the feel smart ones. One was a set of coach nerds and one was a set of coaches. It may not focus much on their studies, but if both these sets come together, we believe that this field can have great talent. Thank you for joining us.
I told you they're a very smart lot, didn't I? Everybody, hello my friends of Goa. Welcome to episode 3 of Off the Field with me, Anish Quenham. Today we're going to talk about a very interesting topic, a topic which has grown with me as a personality in the sports field. Sports for marks or marks for sports? But what exactly this topic is all about, we're going to come to it very shortly. But let me give you a little hint. I can guarantee you, the ones who stand in the top 10 ranks of your class, if you play sports, you're bringing a lot of value to your team. And the ones who don't stand in the top 10, if you try and get into those top 10, you're going to bring in even more value to your sport that you play. With us today in the studio, I've got a very special gentleman, someone who's very, very close to something which I really have a lot of love, connect, and deep, insightful meaning towards, the armed forces of the Indian Army, the Air Force, and the Navy. With me, Commodore Shiv Tiwari. Sir, it's an honor to have you with us in the studio. We're going to explain to viewers what an ex-commando is doing on a sports show very shortly, and we're going to give them the connect with what you're going to say and how that relates to our topic. But before we get there, can you tell us a bit about your journey?
Thank you, Anish. Pleasure to be on your show.
It's an honor to have you.
I think my story relates quite close to your theme, because when we were growing up in the 70s and 80s, we were outdoor people and hardly spent much time indoors. Mm. And I carried that passion into of adventure and joined the Navy and then further specialized as a deep sea diver and a marine commando.
Okay.
So, I couldn't say that...
Let me highlight this. I'm sitting right next to a marine commando right now. Let's go on, sir.
So, most of my lessons I've learned on field. And at the same time, as life went further into my retirement journey, now what I'm pursuing is more intellectual skills. And I think that's where I have struck the balance between initial physical start of a profession and then taking it into a cognitive and a mental sort of a activity, which is keeping me busy now.
So as an ex-Marine commando, someone who's been part of the Indian Navy, this must have been a lot of strategy that actually went into the planning of your work, the planning of your missions. Just the fact that you were protecting us, it required a lot of thought. Was there some sort of a balance always that helped between the right mind and the right body?
Absolutely. I mean, I think it's a question of both dimensions, that is the physical dimension and the mental dimension,
right,
being brought together to work in sync and complement each other as a person. That is when you can deliver. So I would say that being on field, you exercise your physical agility, which also I think develops your mental agility along with your physical conditioning. And at the same time, through education, if you spruce up your cognitive skills, I think it helps you physically implement your ideas and thoughts on ground equally. So I think they complement each other and cannot be in isolation of
right.
each other.
Getting into the topic right now, so this topic basically is trying to educate the viewers that you may stand in the top 10 of your classroom, but that is no excuse for you not to be physically fit. Or you may stand in the bottom 10 of your classroom, and that's no excuse for you to believe that sports is the only thing that can take you there. In fact, education is something that could help you become a better athlete. There must have been times when you were, protecting us, and there were people right next to you. Would it help if the person standing next to you was also intelligent?
Yeah. You started by saying strategy and tactics. Right. I further amplify that. In our profession, when we were in high-risk missions, it was the ability to map that risk quickly, see the consequences, see the impact of what might happen, to stay ahead of the adversary.
Right.
And that cannot be done just by your physical abilities. It has to, you have to bring in your, mental learning and education and your skill sets. And with a combination, can you stay ahead if you want to be a winner? So definitely, I would say, if you're talking about my profession or any other profession, education and applying yourself is equally important mentally as much as physically.
Yet, in Indian education, there isn't much of emphasis given to being physically fit. Why do you think there is a disconnect between getting physically fit and mentally fit?
I think the Indian education system is all about percentages and cutoffs.
Okay.
Now, that's where, in my opinion, I'm not too much in favor of this education model, because real life lessons are learnt on field. The fear of failure, to get away from the fear of failure, you learn when you're on the sports field.
Right.
You learn how to take risks when you're on the sports field.
Right.
So I don't see how you can be successful by purely learning from out of a textbook and then scoring certain percentages and going into the real world.
Right.
And in India, I'm sure we've read a lot about the workforce, their overall skill sets in their performance of their duties. And I think that is lacking because we are not exposing our children enough on the field to learn lessons through experience.
So you believe that, the intelligent children of today who are already so good with their education, if they receive a channel to get out of their classrooms, to get out of their homes, to go beyond their books and maybe learn the real values of life from a sports field, it might even help them in their education?
It will definitely help them in their education, but they will also become tomorrow's leaders and not just be followers.
Right.
To become a leader, you need to learn how to deal with people, situations, and that happens out in field. So you may be highly educated, you may be highly intelligent, but if you can't manage people in your teams, you can't be successful and you won't
be a leader. Tell us something, sir. There are also players or, potential athletes who are watching the show who feel that, it's okay, I'm going to play sports, I'm going to get a couple of grace marks, I know that there's a quota available for me, and I'll scrape through. You think education would help these athletes play better on the field as well? Let's look at it from the other angle.
Yes, certainly will, because if your way or your route to success is through sports, and that's the ticket that you're going to ride, why wouldn't you want to become better at that? by supporting yourself with understanding and learning and educating yourself more on that discipline, I would say.
Right. So I believe that the more time that they would actually spend educating themselves would even maybe make them think better while playing a sport?
Definitely.
Okay. Because, so, you know, in the armed forces, like, you know, even in the Navy, there must have been so many incidents where, you know, players or, you know, people who have joined your ranks have been forced to get into sport. You know, I just read about the website where they've been mentioning about, you know, how the Navy really focuses on getting the people in the ranks fit physically. Can you bring more light to this, and why does the Navy actually focus so much on sport?
Sure. So I think the profession of arms is more about people and teams. Hmm. And the armed forces and Navy is recognized that, that it's not just about using sports to keep you physically fit, but to use it as a tool for organizational development is what I would say.
Right.
And so we have certain select players who are stars.
Yes.
But that doesn't stop sports being across the spectrum of the organization, from the every officer to, you know, every sailor.
Right.
There's a dedicated amount of time per week that you need to spend towards sports, because it's a very, very important tool to keep the organization alive and the Navy's vision, I would say.
Right. So, you know, I think we're coming slowly towards actually backing the topic of the show, Sports for Marks or Marks for Sport, which tell us that there's no point just being mentally fit, or there's no point just being physically fit. There has to be the right balance of the two. And I think if both of them come to the table with the right amount of quantities, you're looking at the perfect human being, not just in sports, not just in the Navy, but a great learning for life.
Absolutely. I couldn't second your statement more than through my personal experience in life, and what you just said is absolutely true.
So a message for the people of Goa who are watching, you know, there could be people who believe that only education is important. There could be even parents who feel that, no, you finish school, you come back home, you open your books, you go to tuitions, you study some more, and then you're back to school tomorrow. What is your message for the people of Goa?
I would say, you know, Goa by itself is a perfect outdoors place. It's not a metro. It offers some amazing environment around you to explore. And especially parents of Goa should encourage their children to get out and experience this aspect of the physical outdoors in combination with the education which is happening here.
Perfect. So we're not done with the show as yet. This is just episode one, or rather segment one of episode three, and it's already so interesting. I'm not going to reveal more details as to how someone who's intelligent is going to benefit the field or vice versa. There's a lot more speakers coming on the show very shortly, but so let me just put it across to you this way. We keep telling our athletes, if you think it's difficult to defend a goal, imagine what it takes to defend a country. It's amazing to have you with us. Thank you so much for your view, and we look forward to welcoming you back shortly.
Thank you, Anish.
When we come back after the break, we are in conversation with a principal. I know all of us have this taboo of, this is what my principal yet has to say, but you have to listen to what this woman is all about and how she used sport to change the entire result culture and, of course, the values in her school. We'll be right back. Thank you.
The all-new Prudent app is here. Watch news videos and bulletins on the go. Catch up with all your favorite programs. Never miss a breaking news with Prudent notification. Watch Prudent TV live on your phone. All new features and a brand new Prudent app. Available for Android and iOS.
Welcome to this segment of Off the Field with me, Anish Kwenem. I'm standing next to Miss Evelette and Antau, who happen to be a principal I worked with at a very close level to make sure that sport has always grown in her school. Ma'am, you've been so supportive of everything that we've done always. And today I'm so privileged to stand with you at this platform right outside your school where we started our journey to understand how sports can benefit somebody. Why have you always been so supportive of sport?
Thank you, Anish, for this opportunity. But I've been passionate about children playing sports because that's what they like to do.
Right.
And they always, you know, enjoy sports. PT period is right. their favorite period, if you just ask them.
Right.
And if they miss one period, they get very, very upset. They right. like to play sports and mostly they enjoy all the games. And we were really indebted to you because of rugby, the passion that you showed, you know, even in the rains, coming here, playing with them and the children. And even now, I think they continue at Chikali ground and they go to Verna without any transport, but they do their best.
Thank you. But do you believe the values from sport? Like, you know, let's talk general about sport, all the sports. There's something which every sport teaches us.
Yeah.
Do you believe that the values from sport help these kids?
Of course, Anish.
In what way?
In what way? First of all, discipline. Hmm. You know, when you play a sport, you have the self-discipline. Hmm. So you, that discipline continues even in the classroom because many a times, you, as children study, they have to have this self-discipline. It is not because a teacher is there or somebody is teaching them. You know, they need to study for the want of studying, so it helps them in the future.
Ma'am, but you say the studying discipline. I mean, we understand that there is a balance. Now, this topic today talks about, you know, sports for marks or marks for sport. Yet, you know, I believe there are children who reach their 10th and the families are like, oh, now this whole year you just have to study. Or you reach your 12th
right.
Right,
right.
Study.
We have a.
Why is this pressure in our
society? This pressure is there on society because right now, today, most of the parents feel, no, just focusing on sports will get them nowhere.
You think that's
there, I don't think so because in sports, I'm saying you get so many qualities or so many things that you learn in sports. Mm. Like you learn discipline, you learn about willpower, you learn to be positive, you learn to, you know, do well, irrespective whatever sports you play. Mm. So those qualities are there even in academics.
Right.
Okay,
right.
So parents, but today that mindset of parents is that, you know, just playing football or children is just playing football, running around here and then get them nowhere, will get them a job nowhere.
Right.
So that is the mindset. Said that we need to
so
change.
You believe that there is a very strong learning that can come from
of
the
course,
field?
Of course, because you learn teamwork, you learn cooperative play, you learn willpower, you learn self-discipline, you learn so many things.
What about loss? Does it also teach you failure?
Of course, it teaches you how to accept. It teaches you to how to accept and see, even in academics today, we teach them like, you know, you have to compete only with yourself, not with the others. Okay, so this sports teaches you that.
Ma'am, you know, from your school, we had done a case study on some of the players with which we had chosen. And then when we went back to see how they were performing in academics, we realized that the smart ones actually brought a lot of value to the field.
You did.
You know, and there is a taboo which yet exists that, oh, studies is it, and or sports is not it.
Correct.
But do you think that the ones who are studying, the educated few, can they bring value to the field?
Of course they can do that because, you know, see what I'm saying, even if they have an interest in any sport, maybe this interest continues in life.
Let's say they don't have an interest. They only want to study. What is your message to them?
I feel we should encourage children right from the primary so that they should be allowed to play any sport, you know, maybe chess or maybe a football or basketball, anything that they like.
Right.
Okay, because which we don't have it in the primary. We start from later level, but they should be arranged. Like they did very well at rugby, which was, there were no marks for that.
Right.
They did very well at rugby.
Talking about marks, you know, we're going to have someone coming on the next segment from the government of Goa, who happens to be Shri Prabhudesai.
Right.
We'll be talking about the marks policy.
Yes.
I think now it's in the open that the students' marks that they're going to get for sport will not really be calculated into their overall percentage. And there could be few people watching the show who'd say, you know what, we're not going to get those marks that we needed. Forget sports once and for all. What is your message to the people watching?
What I feel here, no, this marks for sports, that is mainly the parents' pressure there.
Okay.
The parents push them because you may get a few marks. But children, when they go and play a sport, whether they play football or volleyball or basketball, I don't think they think about the marks that they're getting.
Right.
They just play.
So maybe we can make them think about the value education that they
get out of
sport. Ma'am, as I said, you know, just standing next to you all these years has been such an inspiration.
My pleasure.
And thank you for bringing this value to everyone who's watching this show.
Thank you, Anish.
It's an honor to
have you. For coming once again to meet us.
And we'll keep coming
all
the time.
Yes, yes. Yeah, thank you.
We hope you've enjoyed this segment of Off the Field. I'm standing with the principal of Our Lady of Destero School, who's given her view, as always, so wonderful. We'll see you back in the studio where we have Shri Prabhudesai, who will be waiting for us, who will talk about the actual sports marks policy and what it will do to help the children.